Time now for Consumer Confidential with LA Times columnist David Lazarus.
He's joining us live from the Times newsroom. And David, thousands of Carnival cruise passengers are still at sea, unable to dock because of the coronavirus precautions. So were they just on a cruise? They went on a late cruise?
They went on a cruise, you could say, an ill-advised cruise. And what's extraordinary here is that Carnival released this information not as a press release or an announcement, but in the fine print of a regulatory filing about an upcoming stock offering. And in the filing, they revealed that the company, and remember, Carnival is the world's largest cruise ship operator, the company has 6,000 passengers currently at sea. And that's not the worst of it. Carnival is also acknowledging that these people might have to stay aboard these ships until the end of April. In other words, for another 4 weeks. That's extraordinary. Now, right now, there are more than 24 cruise ships off the coast of Florida trying to get back in, but being denied entry. One ship, the Carnival-owned Zandam, has been saying, we need to dock right away, and Florida is saying no. This after hundreds of people aboard the Zandam have been showing symptoms of COVID-19, and 4 people have died. Meanwhile, the Coast Guard is telling a lot of these cruise ships, most of which have foreign flags, like, say, Panama, to dock in their home ports if they want to get some help. In other words, the Coast Guard is saying, don't turn to us if you've got a foreign flag. Go back where you came from. That, too, is an exceptional development. But you got to feel for these 6,000 people aboard these ships being told, hopefully being told, you might be at sea for another 4 weeks.
Yeah, and you know the buffet's gone at this point.
Oh, forget about that. Yeah. Moreover, you've seen every movie they have on board, let's face it.
Yeah. I mean, plus you can't have it a buffet in these times. All right, there's an oil price war and fewer people driving because of the health precautions. That is combined for the lowest gas prices we have seen in years.
Yeah, it's very rare, Glenn, that I get to say on the plus side, but on the plus side, according to AAA, the national average price per gallon for gas is now $1.99. In other words, under $2 a gallon. And according to AAA, that's the case at roughly 70% of gas stations nationwide right now. As you noted, there's a price war going on between Russia and the Soviet and Saudi Arabia, and that has pushed the price of oil down considerably. That's been a key factor. But the other obvious major factor here is that, well, people are staying home. They are not driving as much, and I just want to say, as someone is driving on the 405 every day, thank you. But that lack of demand has also pushed the price down. But again, when we talk about the average price nationwide being under $2 a gallon, that's not the case here in California. What is it here? In California and in Los Angeles, the price is about $3 a gallon. And can I also say that even though you two are sitting 20 feet apart, I love the way that you've coordinated Lou's dress with Glenn's tie. So well done. Nice value added. Back to you.
Thank you, David. You know, we never coordinate. It's just one of those weird things.
Yeah, it happens. We kind of went through
you're
a
really
dry spell.
You're really disappointing. I'd like to think that you're doing, you know.
Well, we hit the mark today, but we kind of went through a dry spell. But
it's
for a while there, it was like every day we were matching. It was kind of crazy.
I know.
Yeah.
And then the hat trick when I actually pull it off, too.
Yeah, exactly. Well, good to see you, David. All right. So.